Hello, River King fans. My name is Rodney Wilson alongside Keith Papineau. Today, we're down at the Summer Heights Golf Course for the first Cornwall River Kings Golf Tournament. We've gotten an inside look at the River Kings this summer, and today we're going to see if these hockey players can swing a golf club. Enjoy.
Play where it lies, happy.
Should I ask you a question?
Sure.
What happens when your ball is behind a couple of twigs and a tree like that?
You're supposed to shoot anyway.
You should shoot.
But then we play best ball, so you go and pick it up and you just...
I think this is your best shot, though. I don't know.
No, I don't think so. There's one right in front of the green.
Par 5, Mario Jolie.
Right.
There's a tap in for birdie. Joined now by Mario Jolie's wife. And I have a question for you. Tiger Woods' wife, she found out about the cheating. I think she clubbed him with a 7 iron. He comes home one night. What club do you use on him?
If he did, you can rest assured there'd be a hole in one, and he'd be the one.
Ooh. A driver?
Oh, that would hurt.
I think a driver. I think I would go for a driver.
Are you having fun out here?
Sure.
So what's better, being married to a hockey player or a golfer?
I'm going to have to go with hockey.
Here's Mario Jolie straight off a birdie.
Yeah, was a good shot, Licky, so we'll take that.
At the first one of the day?
Yeah, first one.
Now, we've met Mario Jolie, the hockey player. Today we get to meet Mario Jolie, the golfer.
Pretty exciting over here. It's a fun day, so we're having fun. It's just to relax.
We've got
a beer girl, so.
There we go. We've got a couple of golfers behind us, so maybe we should walk this way.
Yeah.
Have you seen Happy Gilmore, the movie?
Oh, yeah, I did. Yeah, Sasha is going to show us that the next hole, right? Sasha is going to do it. It's pretty
so
good.
Who wins in a fight, you or Happy Gilmore?
I would say Happy Gilmore. Yeah, it's tough.
What two records does he hold?
For punching Bob Barker,
yeah.
The guy, and and I don't know the other one.
He's the only player to ever attempt to stab somebody else with a skate.
Ah, that's true. I forgot about that.
10 years ago in this league, did that ever happen to you?
No, never happened. But I saw some pretty crazy stuff.
Maxim Daigneau, Cornwall River Kings goaltender, and Sasha Pokaluk, first round draft pick of the River Kings, of course. Sasha, you're the first overall pick. You get a caddy today.
Oh, Max is taking care of me. He's my personal driver.
Yes, I'm the caddy today.
So, Sasha's 150 yards out. What club do you tell him to use?
About a 7.
7 iron? All
yeah.
Right. So you guys got a birdie there, minus 1 through 4?
We're actually even, I think.
Even?
Yeah.
So you had a bogey.
Yeah, bogey on the second hole, I think.
And you guys have two caddies and you still got a bogey.
That's on them, man.
You guys know it's best ball, right?
Yeah. We know.
You guys have seen Happy Gilmore at all?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you guys know that they're going to be filming part 2?
They didn't know that.
They just announced that this week.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Any of your teammates that you think might be maybe filling the role of Adam Sandler?
Mario Jolie is a good one.
Yeah. I bet you he stabbed somebody with a skate before.
Has he ever punched anybody out on the golf course?
I wouldn't bet against it.
Oh, you played for the Windsor Wild last year. I think 7-4-1 last year. Just signed by the team now. What do you think about the changes that Wayne has made so far?
It's pretty good so far. Like, you bring few new guys and like Milosh, and they signed a few good guys like Sasha, signed Lessard for a good fighter, so very exciting to start a season.
What have you heard about Cornwall and maybe its hockey fans, and what are your first impressions on this city?
I know a guy from not too far from me, Bobby Mazarol, and he told me back in the day Cornwall was very, like, they love the fighting and they love the tough game, so I'm sure this year they're going to be happy with us.
Well, you guys are up on the tee. Thanks for doing this. Introduce Cornwall fans to the owner, the man responsible for bringing this team to Cornwall, Bernie Villeneuve.
Hey, appreciate that. Thank you. And we're just doing our golf tournament today, first time around. We don't expect the biggest thing for the tournament, but hey, take it at ease. You always got to start somewhere. And I hope everybody has a great time. And I appreciate all the sponsorship and in town. Everybody's been helping us out. I mean, way and above everything.
It's been a fun summer for you, a little bit of stress, but on a day like today, time to get out with the players and maybe enjoy yourself a little bit?
Oh, definitely on that one. I think Al's swinging away there. We're looking for Happy Gilmore right now. I don't know if he's in the zone or not, but he could be up next.
The green's that way. Sure. Nice shooting, soldier!
Joined now by hockey player and certainly not golfer, Steve Samos. Rough day out there, Steve?
No. For those watching, it was a fantastic day. I played, I think I hit 80. It's looking pretty good out there. Tom Daly gave me a few pointers yesterday. I definitely don't play golf. I'm horrible. I can't even tell you how bad I was, but it was all in good fun. It was a great time to meet everybody. Finally, I mean, the first time you meet everybody, you kind of not too sure what to say, and the second time you just lose all inhibition and pretty much say what you want. So it was a good chirp fest, and the weather cooperated slightly till the 17th hole, and then we got drenched, but it was great. It was a good time.
Now, you've seen the movie Happy Gilmore, I'm sure. You were practicing out there a little bit.
Yeah.
We want to know, who would win in a fight, you or Happy Gilmore?
Bob Barker would definitely kick my ass. he's pretty tough. Happy's a wuss. I mean, we got a couple guys that I saw today that definitely got some good size there. Brennan's got a pretty good build to him. Even Eric Milosh, I told him he's gonna start scrapping this year at the size he is. I didn't know it was that big. And then obviously Mario Gioli looked yeah, pretty big. I mean, the fact that he's missing his two front teeth kind of intimidates me. But no, he's a good buddy, and it was fun to see everybody. It was just like I said. It's just we've been rivals in the past. I mean, we've played against each other throughout our careers for the last 7-8 years for some of the guys, and it's weird how you kind of leave it on the rink and you get here. And when you wear the same colors, you get this kind of camaraderie, and it's a good start. I'm not gonna lie to you. We have a good attitude so far.
Yeah. Now, Happy Gilmore 2, I guess, is going to be filming. We're talking about doing a remake of that. Any acting experience, or I think maybe you can be a stunt double for maybe Adam Sandler?
Yeah.
Or a skater, maybe?
You know, I'd love to do it. You know, the camera doesn't bother me, so I don't. I'm not shy at all. So, if they need me, call me. Let me know. I mean, 514-9. No. I'm not a golfer, man. I like to keep it to the ice. Let's focus on the Cornwall River Kings first, yeah, and then worry about the acting career later. Let's put on a good show. You put on a good show when you win and when everybody's happy. So that's the main attitude we're getting from the main vibe from most of the players is, listen, it's something new, it's something fresh. We've heard about the fan support that we're going to get, so don't let me down. But we've heard it's going to be unreal, so now we're just like, hey, well, if they're coming, then let's give them something to cheer about. And the only cheer when you win, and the only cheer when you actually pour your heart out, which is what the way we play. So like I said, it's a good base, and let's hope our acting careers don't depend on us making money.
Is there already a few games that you're looking forward to on the schedule? You know, you've been in the league for a few years now. We're talking to Mario last week, and he's got a few guys he's looking forward to playing. There's gonna be some good rivals this year because you're playing Ontario against,
yeah,
Quebec
course,
teams.
Absolutely.
It's gonna be a fun year.
It's gonna be a fun year. I think the first game is definitely opening night here. We play our first game on the road, I believe, against Sorel. And then the next game is here at home on a Saturday, I believe. And that's definitely the first one. I think no matter how old you get and no matter what caliber of hockey you play, I mean, the butterflies in the stomach. And if you don't, then obviously you shouldn't be playing. Because, I mean, the reason we still play is we have that passion for it. It's not for the money. It's per se. It's for the camaraderie. And I was talking to Al about that. I'm like, Al, how do you feel coming back? He's like, it's weird. It's been 3 years, and it's nice to just kind of be with boys, and everybody just kind of gets on each other's back, and it's a unity you don't have anywhere else. I mean, if you're playing chess or playing badminton, you definitely won't feel it. So it's good to get that base going. But every game for us will be the same. I mean, there's personal rivalries. I mean, I've played for Thetford Mines, and I've played for Rivière du Loup, and I've had good relationships where I was. But there's players who've been traded there that, yeah, we kind of didn't get along. So a coach in particular and my old team, which I can't mention, but you can find it online. You'll see. He used to coach here. I mean, he's not a bad guy, just not my kind of guy. So we nearly scrapped in warm up one time. So just letting you know that eventually, politically correct, I'll say eventually his time will come.
All right.
I mean, I'm still playing, so that's all I'm saying.
Now, if there are any fisticuffs or anything like that, you've got some pretty big guys back on D, especially. I don't think anyone's going to be pushing Cornwall around, safe to say?
It's safe to say that I'll be pushing people around in my own end, in the defensive zone, because I know the guys are there. We got some big boys. I mean, I just saw Sully. Sullivan looks good. You got Brennan. The only thing with Sullivan, he cut his hair. I can't believe he did that. He had a great flow going, and he just cut it. I'm kind of disappointed. Then you got, I mean, Sash. I think Sash will probably be able to defend himself, but he's definitely not here for that, and that's what we don't want him here for. He put the puck in the net. We'll be happy with that. Yves Sereau, believe it or not, the 39-year-old can still throw him. He threw last year. We all wanted to jump in. He's like, back away, I got this. So, I mean, he can definitely defend himself, and then Mario well. Mario, it's safe to say that last year, we were talking with Eric Milosh about it, and Mario, they were in situations last year where they weren't completely comfortable. And when you're not completely comfortable, you're not going to want to give your all. And
step up for your teammates.
Yeah, because you know that they don't step up for you. Yeah. I mean, some players are a little selfish, and the first thing we're trying to do is make sure that, listen, I got your back, you got mine, and from that point on, you can kind of build a nice relationship forward, and you don't want to kind of step on the wrong toes off the hop, and that's what we're kind of getting to. I mean, and I'll do it. I know Eric will do it. I know Mario will do it. I know Sully will do it, so we'll get to know each other well, and when that happens, you kind of intimidate a team toughness. It's not really individual. You don't need Danik Lassard, who's got over 500 fights, to start scrapping, which we want him to, but we want this team toughness that we have to be imposed. And listen, you're coming to Cornwall. The minute you cross the border, you know you're gonna get your ass kicked.
There you go.
I mean, you're gonna get pushed around, depending on the score. I mean, we want to win hockey games. Everybody loves a winner. I mean, like, let's not kid ourselves. If you only win when you play hard. You only really have fun when you win. So it's an attitude Al's definitely letting us know, and it's respectable. And trust me, we're gonna make sure that the fans of Cornwall definitely respect us, because we're gonna respect them.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Well, thanks for doing this, Steve.
No problem. I can't believe it took this long.
All right, joined now by Eric Milosh, the former Cornwall Colts sniper picked up by the River Kings this summer. Eric, first of all, welcome back to Cornwall.
Thanks. Yeah, it's good to be back.
I think that was the very first move that Wayne went ahead and made when we got the team. Were you surprised by it, or had you talked to Wayne previously?
You know what? I talked to Al previously, so I didn't know it was coming, but when they made the first move, Al made sure he gave me a call before, and you know, I was very happy. If Cornwall had a team, I'm glad to be part of it.
Now, you've played in the league last year, actually, after 5 years, I think, over in Germany. How do you compare the playing overseas and then the Quebec League?
Well, it's not really the same league. The Quebec League has a lot of great players, but it's a weekend league, and you don't practice every day. And in Europe, you know, you practice every day, and the Olympic ice sheet is... It's a little different, but I mean, it's good caliber hockey. It's a lot of ex-professional players, and you got to be highly skilled to play in the league anyways.
Now, Cornwall's changed quite a bit in the 15 years you've been away. Looking forward to coming back to the city?
You know what, it was funny to be back just driving through the streets. It's been at least, like you said, about 15, 16 years since I've been back, and things have changed, but I'm sure I'll find everything okay.
Now, you've had a pretty lengthy pro career. Must be coming full circle, coming back and playing for Al Wager once again.
Yeah, you know, playing for Al, it was the main reason why I came back. I was actually going to retire after last year, and Al convinced me to come back for at least one more year. So, I'm happy to be back in Cornwall. It's, like you said, it's full circle. And if I was going to stop somewhere, I might as well be here.
What do you bring to the table for this team? Leadership role, obviously you can still put the puck in the net as well. What do you see this season shaping up to be?
You know what, I think Al and Wayne are putting together a pretty good competitive team. There's only 6-7 teams in this league. And I think at 36, I'm due to peak. So I'm hoping to have a good season. You know, I'm mostly looking to have fun in the city, and you know, I have a few more years left, but I mean, I want to enjoy myself, and I think a lot of guys here that are coming here to play are going to want to have to enjoy themselves, but of course you have to win to enjoy yourself, so I think we're here to win, have a good competitive team toughness, and I think they're on the right direction to put everything together.
What do you, exactly, the direction of the team, some huge defensemen back there, solid goaltender, now they're adding some snipers up front, pretty good mix so far from what you see?
Yeah, you know, on paper we look good, but like I said, we have to go out there and do our job, and I think it's going to take a leadership role from the older players to, you know, to put things together. I mean, it is, like I said, it's a weekend league. Guys have jobs, guys have families. Like, it's different from being a full-time professional. It's very sporadic out there, so it's different from the hockey you've seen all the time. So, I mean, it's... You have different guys on the ice at different times, but I mean, it's to put everything together, it's going to be a, you know, a hell of a job for them to do. And if guys like us and can come every day and play and work hard, then commit to the team, I think we'll have no problems.
And what do you tell these guys from Quebec about maybe some guys they don't know, and Al Wager and Mike Rua and the type of teams that they're going to have?
You know, I think they'll be able to explain themselves what kind of people they are. They're pretty straightforward. You know what, they like to have fun, but yet they want you to work hard. So, you know, if you want to have fun, work hard, and I think you'll have no problems with anybody in this whole town. I think if you come here to play, I think the town will respect you, and like they did when I was here 15 years ago. Like you said, we worked hard, we played well, and we had a great time. So I don't think things will change in this league either.
Well, thanks for doing this, Eric, and welcome back to Cornwall.
Thank you.
Joined now by Stéphane Lachapelle, no stranger to Cornwall, former Hawkesbury Hawk. What's it like to be coming to town now and playing for this team?
It feels good to be back in this area. Didn't know if I'd ever come back this way, but to come back and kind of revisit the old memories, it's kind of nice. And the idea of playing here and back in front of the fans now in a Cornwall jersey should be a little bit better that way. So I'm excited.
Now, you're living in Toronto, so you committing to the River Kings for every weekend, you know, it's going to be quite a trip for you. I must say a lot about what you think about this team and the direction they're going.
Well, you know, when Al told me about the program that's started here, it's a great opportunity for me. In Toronto, I know it seems to be a little bit of a trek to make it down every weekend, but I don't mind. I'm really excited to play for the team, and, you know, it's not too far down the road, and to be able to play at that level and under Al and, you know, with the group of guys that they put together here, I'm very excited, and the drive doesn't bother me too much.
You mentioned Al, of course, you played for Al Wager in Hawkesbury. What was he like as a coach then, and what can you expect from him maybe at the senior level here?
Al was a great coach for us too. Beside Rick Lalonde there, he was kind of assistant. He sat back a little bit, but from what I learned from him and what I know of him as a person and as a coach, I'm really, really happy to be playing for him again. And I look forward to it. He's a great coach, and he's done great things with the Colts in the past and with the teams he's coached, and I'm sure I expect nothing less from this team this year.
After playing in the CJHL, you went overseas and played in France. What was that experience like playing pro hockey over there?
It's fun. Overseas, definitely a great experience. You know, you get to see different places of the world and play a little different styles of hockey and with players from different countries and whatnot. All in all, a great experience, and I had a lot of fun over there. And you know, I look forward to get back to the North American style and back playing at home.
Yeah. Cornwall's got definitely a tough team that not too many guys are going to want to come to Cornwall to play against, but also adding some skill up front now. Maybe tell us about your game and what you bring to the table.
You know, I like to think of myself as a bit of a diverse player, able to play all areas. Basically, I'm just going to kind of take in any role Al wants to give me or whatever the team, you know, expects from me. I'm just going to come give it 100% every night and work hard. And I know it's a tough league from what I hear. I don't know too much about the league, but from what I hear, it's highly competitive and very tough. So, you know, I look forward to the challenge, and I'm just going to bring, you know, everything I have to the table every night and just, you know, see whatever I can contribute to the team day in, day out.
Well, thanks for doing this, and we look forward to seeing you at training camp.
Thanks very much.